shine. Diamonds in my teeth, I got a lot of shine. Running up the number, that's a lot of crime. Try to take it from me, must be out your mind. I need a lot of sun. Smokey in the air, that's a lot of pine. Pockets running over with the dollar sign. Try to take it from me.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage, Stacy Spikes.
Excited to be here. Oh, mic's dead.
Great. Okay, here we go.
So really excited to be here, and we have so much fun stuff to talk about today. I'm going to break it up into three different parts. So first, we're going to talk about basically what had happened. Then we're going to talk about where we are, and then we're going to talk about where we're going. That sound good? Yeah. Excellent. Excellent. So before we get started, I want to say how honored I am to actually be here. And I'm going to talk a little bit about, you know, some of the things and the inspirations that got us here. But we're in Lincoln Center and we're having this moment and it's unbelievable. So let's get started. So once upon a time back in startup land, there were these two entrepreneurs who had this idea. And they wanted to be able to make movie going easier, and they wanted to be able to, you know, get more butts in seats and help people go. And that's me and Hamay, if you can't tell, my original co-founder. So as we got started and we started to build it out, and some of you are in the audience with me who helped do that and helped build that and helped make that, MoviePass became this, you know, dare I say, cult following that people really loved and adored. Just the idea took charge. And it was inspiring. And just like many startups and founders, we got to a point that we had to raise more capital and try and keep the dream going and build it up to the next level. And let's just say the management and the ownership of the company went from these two guys to these two guys. And the, you know, there was a really big difference in the belief of the way the company should go forward and how we should take it to its next level. And we all kind of know what happened after that. So the reason we're here today, that's all behind us, is actually to talk about something new and arise. So thank you for being here today at this moment. It really means something. So I wanted to take a moment, though, actually to talk a little bit about actually what happened and kind of just not fly over it. There's a couple of things that I want to bring up. A lot of people lost money. A lot of people lost trust. There were a lot of people who were hurt and disappointed. And I was one of those people who was disappointed and hurt too. And if you don't know, at a certain point, right when we started the new deal and the new company, I got fired from the company that I founded, was ousted, and that was a really hard thing to take. Now I'm gonna go off on a little tangent here for a moment, but follow me. We ran into something that a lot of diverse founders run into. That's the ability to access capital. And the reason I bring that up is one of the reasons I wanted to help bring this back is to really focus and show that it's important that diverse founders are able to access capital so they too can make their dreams come true. You had two very seasoned entrepreneurs who knew the game and had been around the block. And that actually, at the end of, in my personal opinion, caused a lot of the problems because we couldn't keep the engine going. And other people just have access to capital like it was nothing. So that was a very big problem. The other thing that, only 3% of capital that is deployed goes to women and minorities. And that has to change in America. So one of the things is that the way we look at the world is we spend a lot of money to go to the movies, to support theaters, to do all of these things. But that money, when it comes back down in the spirit of entrepreneurship and being able to be part of the solution and create new ideas, it doesn't rain back down the same way. It only goes to a small portion of people. So there's people, if you guys don't know, this is also being live simulcast. You know, we want to be able to push more accountability. So actually, you don't see things that happen to MoviePass happen in the future. So I wanted to kind of take a side note to bring that up because that is a pressing issue that we all need to address. So thank you for that. Now, the second point I want to bring up is the issue of the reason I'm so fortunate in Black History Month to be able to be standing on this stage in Lincoln Center is the hard work and sacrifice of so many people that came before us, whether it was through civil rights and other things for me to be able to be here. And I stand on the shoulders of giants for that to be possible. And I want to make sure that my presence is saying to a little brown boy or a little black girl out there, you too one day can stand here if you fight for your dreams. All right, so thank you for letting me do that little tangent. So the biggest thing when I was sitting at home feeling sorry for myself, my wife is in the audience and she knows. She got a firsthand look. There were certain points she's like, you have to go do something. You can't just sit here. And I was like, but why? I'm going to start a business and they're just going to steal it from me. but it was the fans who actually really kept the dream alive. You guys really kept the dream alive. There were times where I just kept reading, will it come back? Can it come back? We hope it comes back. I loved it. It changed my life. I was, the feedback that you had was amazing. And so I want to show you, this is a TikTok video that actually just came out a few months ago. So people were posting things like this. You'd see arguments in the Reddit chat rooms. People were saying, I went to 900 movies and other ones. You were the one who put MoviePass out of business. fighting online. And so it was just really good to see the spirit of people wanting it. And I have to tell you, when the way this all went down, so there is, if you haven't heard, there is a documentary film crew who's making a movie on MoviePass, right? And so the producer called me up and said, hey, I heard that MoviePass is still available and nobody bought it out of bankruptcy. And I said, what are you talking about? And that was Scott. I told Scott today is all his fault, by the way. And so I called up the bankruptcy attorneys and I said, is it true that no one bought MoviePass? And they're like, yeah. And so we bidded on it and we had to wait for 21 days. I don't think I slept for those 21 days. And lo and behold, the judge granted our motion. And the impossible happened. And so, but there is no way that that wouldn't have happened if you guys weren't there. So one of the things that we were trying to figure out as we unroll this and come back, we've been looking at this as from a different point of view. Can we do this as a cooperative that we rebuild MoviePass from the first time as a company that is built by its fan base, that we are actually the business, that we become a body like a co-op that actually buys tickets in the marketplace and works from that point of view. And so we want to be able to allow you to be our owners. We want to do it a little bit differently this time. We believe that you believe better than some VCs might believe, and because of your passion and your spirit. So today, we actually are making a portion of the company available to anybody who wants to be able to invest in it and have ownership in it. And so we're going to make that effective. You'll be able to go on the website and find out more about it, but we're going to do that. And then, yeah. So in addition to that, there's going to be plenty of benefits for owners and members, and one of those levels is actually going to be a lifetime membership to MoviePass. So, getting water. So, all right. Thanks. You guys are great. This is fun. Okay. So, basically going from where we were, where we are, and where we're going to go, I want to give you some stats about what you guys did and how you behaved and where you went and all of that fun stuff. So you grew to 3 million users. You saw 50 million movies in a single year. You went to 4,000 different theaters. And in a single year, you became 4% of the entire market. Give yourselves a hand. In 2018, the market lifted a total of 6% overall just off of the behavior of MoviePass customers. So what was really interesting when we got the data back and we started to look at it was the impact. Now, we didn't move the needle on Spider-Man or Star Wars or anything like that. We weren't going to. But we found a huge impact in specialty, independent, and Oscar contenders. And some of these titles you actually can see here. And the traffic that we drove to independent and art house theaters was very significant. This graph that you see behind me shows a spike of where the MoviePass behavior went above the average of the rest of the market. That's the power of what you guys were able to do towards the box office. Quite amazing. If you looked at MoviePass as if it was an exhibitor across the entire nation in that year, we would rank number 3 if we were a virtual exhibitor. If you took the number 1 market, New York, we would be the second largest exhibitor in that market. And if you also took the New York market, we were number 1 in all sales for Won't You Be My Neighbor. Almost 55% of ticket sales for Won't You Be My Neighbor came through MoviePass. It's crazy, right? Amazing. So what do we do for a second act, right? How are we going to come back? How are we going to make this bigger, better, stronger, faster? So we sat down and we started to think. Now, there's some complaints. Many of you know, because of COVID, we all hear, is movies doomed? Are they over? I don't know about you, but I don't think so. So we were asking ourselves, well, why is it that people constantly are comparing movies and saying, you know, it's the end? When you think of sports, the live event is the game, right? When you think of music, the live event is the concert. And when you think of movie going, the live event is cinema. And so a lot of times people correlate movie going as a form of distribution when actually it's a live event. And did you know that movie going is the number one out-of-home entertainment activity in the world? Worldwide. And a lot of people don't realize that. More than sporting events, amusement parks combined, movie going is number one in the world. Movie going is not going anywhere. Cinema is not going anywhere. So we were thinking big, and we thought, we're really going to think big. According to our data, we realize that if 30% of moviegoers became subscribers, like we did almost in a single year, we could double the annual revenue and attendance of the overall movie industry. So we got a bit of a moonshot that we want to throw out. And this is not just for us, but this would be for the entire industry. Our moonshot is to get to 30% by 2030. If we start to become a strong enough subscription base, now studios don't have to worry, are they going to come? Will they be there? Because we've found that when people join MoviePass, they increase their behavior anywhere from 100 to 144%, and they go more often. So that's our moonshot. Our challenge to the industry is we'd like to see us get by 2030 to 30%. Will you guys help us do that? We don't need millions of people to start. We just need 300. So thank you for being here. All right. So our other big goal and a big idea was we wanted to be able to build the first end-to-end cinematic marketplace. So what does that mean? Right now, there's something built for studios, and there's something built for theaters. But there's nothing built for us that we actually are the center of. We want to be able to help software solve that problem and be able to bring us all together more efficiently. And we want to build that with Web3 technologies. And that's our vision of the future. So the big thing that everybody said to us was, hey, there are these other exhibitors since you've been gone, theater chains. And those theater chains, while you were gone, have these subscription services that are now more effective, and they're up and they're running. So what are you going to do about that? So we thought about it, and there's something that we noticed. If it benefits one theater chain, it's really a loyalty program. But if it benefits the entire market, then what you actually have is a marketplace. Our goal is to create a marketplace where all theaters, all movies, all titles, all parts of the market benefit. And that's very important to us. We can't outbeat them in what they're doing for their own particular circuit. So we didn't want to take our own word for it. We actually ran a poll nationwide. We asked, how many people, if prices were basically the same, would want the ability to go to all theaters and have a subscription plan that benefited that? 75% of people said this is what they would prefer. So we think we have a chance in the market. All right. So now you're asking, well, when am I going to be able to sign up for MoviePass? This summer. So we are coming. A lot of our engineers are here and also watching online. And they are working very hard. And I'm going to show you some of the things, not only that they're working, but some things that are coming of the new and improved MoviePass and how it's different. But I really want to give it up to our engineering team. The engineering team has also been the same engineering team that was our original founding engineering team. So if you guys could give them a hand, please do. They have been to hell and back. So, before I give you some of the details about that, we actually did, to my partner on this tour of duty, her name is Gretchen, and Gretchen comes from the theater side of the business. And so we started doing a listening tour where when we knew we had MoviePass back, we contacted studios, we contacted theaters, we contacted members, and we started having a conversation. And we took everything that they were saying and put it in a box and said, okay, what does everybody want? What did they not have from the first MoviePass, and what do they want from the new MoviePass? Studios wanted to be able to talk to you directly and market to you directly. They want to be able to have a better line of communication with you. That was one thing that we noticed. They want to be able to know, well, this person comes to see every James Bond. Let's give them something good for supporting us and get them back early. And then this person never comes. How do we convince them to come and see this movie? Right? And if we have this art house title, how do we get that person to be able to try it? And what we found was people didn't see MoviePass as a discount. They saw it as a discovery tool. Right? There's those titles that they said, well, I got my MoviePass. Let me go check it out. Right? did anybody see Drive My Car yet? Isn't it great? That's an example of one of those movies that you go out and you try something new. And so there's those titles that you're going to give a chance because it's like, hey, I'm going to go give them a try. So that's what we heard from the studios. The theaters said, I want to be able to market to them directly. I want to be able to promote different off-peak hours. I want to be able to promote different prices to them. I want to be able to offer them concessions. I want to be able to do things that'll get them to come to my theater on times when I'm not busy. So these were some of the things that we heard from people. So can I show you guys some of the new things that are coming? Okay. All right. So first off, we're going to introduce that we're going to have virtual currency in the system. Now, what that means is you're going to have credits, and those credits you're going to be able to use in in different ways. And that was one of the things that the theaters said, hey, I'm a little guy. I want to be able to get them to come to my theater. So I want to be able to offer them things and be able to do that. So the credit system adds a marketplace that they're going to be able to compete. The second thing is these credits are going to roll over. So if you didn't go 1 month or you underused them, you're going to be able to roll those over and use those credits as well. The third thing is you're going to be able to bring a friend. So you're going to the movies and you've got your credits and you say, hey, I want to bring a friend. And before, the movie pass that we had, it was one person. You couldn't bring a friend. You couldn't do it with anybody else. So that was a thing that we heard from you as a consumer, that you wanted to be able to bring somebody. So we're really excited about that. Then you're going to be able to make your credits tradable. So part of the Web3 universe that we're talking about is maybe I haven't gone in a month or two, and I might want to transfer some of my credits to you. So, you know, if grandma hasn't gone and she hasn't used some of her credits, you're going to be able to do that. There's the dev team's still working on some of the details of that, but that is something that's going to be part of it. And last part is we're going to have tiered plans. So the tiered plans are going to be able to allow you to come in at a place that you feel more comfortable with. What we saw was $10 was a really good starting point for a lot of people who said, I don't know if I'm going to use it or not. I don't know how much I'm going to go. And other people were at higher levels and saying, yeah, I want more. Well, the tiered system is going to let different people play at different levels. And so we're excited to have that as well. These are the new features that are coming in the new MoviePass. Can I show you some slides of it? So, all right. We were debating whether we should show anything. It's been in beta for a while, and I'm going to show you some of the different pieces of it. So these are actual screenshots, actually from my phone. And what you'll notice is there's actually credits and credits. So you're going to have peak and off-peak times that you're going to be able to use the credits differently. So now, when you have your total number of credits, you're going to be able to say, well, you know what? I want to use fewer credits on that. But you might say, it's Friday or Saturday night. I want to use more. And the theater is going to be able to promote different things on their peak and off-peak times. This actually just shows you part of the flow. We currently have it where we've been testing it offline that we haven't plugged into the API. And so we can use the card and be able to do it that way. So that's a first look into the new app that's already up and running. All right, so this is where things really start to get interesting. We've always offered inside of MoviePass all theaters, okay? And then right towards the end, we were starting to partner with theaters. And those theaters, again, had a certain advantage because if you remember, there was the card system where you had to go to leave your house, go down to the theater, and you had to go to the, you hoped it wasn't sold out and you'd swipe your card. Remember? And then we added partnering theaters, and those theaters, you could actually select your seat before you left your house. Okay? So, we're bringing that back where partnering theaters will be able to partner. And there's some examples, but I want to show you some data. Watch this. This is an example of a theater circuit that before they integrated with our API, now they're already in our system. You can see what was happening, where people were going. What we found was every time a theater plugged into our API, you can see the type of change that happened to attendance of people going to their theater. It drove new traffic anywhere from 30 to 40% higher when they integrated with the MoviePass API. So we said, okay, we're going to bring all of that back, but now we're going to let the theater even, like I said, offer things to you and be able to promote and drive traffic to you. So for example, let's say I've been going to a theater for a while, but all of a sudden I start to drift and go to something else. That theater could actually promote and actually draw me back and offer things to me, be able to get me back. They could never do that before in the old app. There was no way, there was no integration. They didn't see any of that. That's gonna come. Please give it up for our engineering team for all of the, yeah. So starting today, any circuit that wants to be part of this partnering system, they can go to moviepass.com and they can actually start filling out the forms. There is no charge to be able to be a partnering theater. It is free to be able to integrate with us. We pick up all of that cost, but they're going to be able to do that. So can I show you guys some of the new theaters that are coming up? People think of theaters as old and run down. And so this is a Sinopolis that's in Texas. Yeah, Carl knows that one. Flicks Brewhouse. Look at these theaters. These are gorgeous. Look at this one. Museum of Moving Image. Warehouse Cinemas. Brand new circuit with our friend Brian is Look Cinemas. all of those in Texas. We know Alamo Draft House and the new one here in Brooklyn. And my favorite that I still go to all the time is Angelica. I'm always in screen 3 or 4 on a Saturday about 5 o'clock. Sounds like you are too. Okay, so that's where we've been and where we are. So now we want to talk about where we're going. This second part to this second act. So what we realize is in order to make MoviePass relevant for this new phase, we need to build it in Web3. Web3 gives you more power to your own data, gives you more control, it gives you more freedom, and it takes the middleman out versus people selling your data and giving away information for you to have access to things. We're gonna empower that happens directly to you. So I wanna talk to you about something we've been working on for a while that we're very excited about, which is called pre-show. So, how many of you know about pre-show? Okay. By the way, I wanted to ask this earlier before I go into this. How many of you were MoviePass members? How many of you still have your MoviePass card? It's great. I held on to mine too, so, all right. So we all love, I'll speak for myself for a second. I love product placement in movies. I love the cars, I love the watches, I love the clothes. I'm that person that I sometimes have a notepad and I'm writing down, is that Hugo Boss? And I'm on the computer trying to figure out what suit is he wearing? I'm that guy. And one of the things is, believe it or not, Madison Avenue spends $11 billion a year in product placement. So if the box office is $11 billion a year, and product placement is $11 billion a year, don't you think it makes more sense that they just spend that money with us instead of needing to try and get to us? Maybe they could just speak to us directly. So, pre-show, the concept that we had was, why are we trying to have them go and spend third party to get to our attention? Maybe what we could do is, let me watch that content and you could cover the cost of the ticket because you're spending advertising dollars someplace else. So it's a way to close that loop and make it far more efficient of a system. Here's some other examples of this. So if you haven't seen it, I'd like to show you a little bit about pre-show. And I want to do a live demo for you. Can I do that?
Yeah.
Great. Let me come over here and do this.
Should have screen open, James.
Just getting the screen to come up. So the premise is, all right, perfect. So I'm gonna have Mark hold this while I, so I could go in, so inside of the new MoviePass, you're gonna be able to go in and you're gonna be able to see a movie that you are interested in seeing. But let's say I want to be able to get extra credits, earn extra credits for that film, or I maybe even want to be able to see it for free. And the advertisers have put a pre-show together, not unlike what you normally would see when you go into a movie theater, but this is customized for you. So I'm going to go in. And so part of the direction that we're doing from a Web3 perspective is, this is happening only on your phone, uniquely to you, and the credits that earn are your credits that go into your virtual wallet that you get to spend. So it's your own money. Now, what's cool about this is Your phone, your device, uses your own facial detection. It doesn't go to the cloud. Nobody goes through anything other than you and your information and yours. And you opt in to do it on your own. So what it does is it basically creates a transaction between you and the brand. So I'm going to come here, and as I'm looking at it, it's playing back. But if I stopped and I'm not paying attention to it, it actually pauses the content. So we had an earlier version of this where you know what happened. People put the phone down, left, didn't pay any attention to it, and it would be... Right now, 70% of advertising, video advertising, is unseen. So this is a way that the advertiser is getting the impact they're looking for, but you're also getting the impact yourself. So I'm going to keep watching this. It's a short spot, but there'll be different lengths and according to the brand. So when I see something like a James Bond, it's got Hugo Boss suits, Aston Martin car, Land Rover. You know, there's tons of brands in there. Well, I could interact with those brands. And this is Zeus, and they're a driverless taxi service. So Zeus could offer me a ride, and they could offer me additional points if I actually go and take a ride. That'll all be able to happen in the app. So this is going to play through. And it tells me I've completed the pre-show. Thanks, Mark. And we can go back. So it tells me I've completed the pre-show, and now that digital currency comes to me. So that's part of the Web3 that we've been focused on, is being able to get the middleman out that is your direct benefit. So we're excited to be able to show you guys this. Thank you. all right. There's one more thing that I wanted to talk about before we end, I let you go. So part of that thank you that we talked about earlier is that commitment that people had, being able to stick it out, and that you appreciated a brand, and so many of you defended us when we were online, and just watching the community and how people reacted was just amazing. So what we wanted to be able to do to those of you who showed up today and supported us again and being able to come out and you're the early adopters, I want to deputize you all and turn you into beta users and have you be the first ones to be able to test the app for a whole year for free. So there's responsibilities that go with that. That means we're going to be looking for your feedback. We're going to be looking for your ideas. Everybody who came and your QR code got scanned, you're already in the system. And we just wanted to show you a form of our appreciation that you came out and you were so willing to support us. So thank you very much for that. So some point during the summer, you're going to get emails to give you some timing around when that's going to happen. We'll pull you in first. Like I said, start to give us actual feedback. We'll create a feedback loop. If you find bugs, if you find things. So we're going to put you to work. Don't think it's all free. But we just love getting your thoughts and ideas and things that you're going to suggest that we might do, or things that feel bumpy. Look, we're going to make mistakes, right? We're not going to get it right out of the box. It's going to be trial and error. But if you guys can help us build a marketplace, we really think we can take this place. It's because it bugs me how people talk about the end of the movie industry. And I'm like, what are you talking about? It's the greatest thing on earth. So I want to thank you all for being here today. I want to thank you for coming out, and I appreciate your continued support, and thank you for being here today. Thank you. Yeah.
number nine. Diamonds in my teeth, I got a lot of shine. Running up the number, that's a lot of crime. Try to take it from me, must be out your mind.